I noticed that the flag was at half mast, is at half mast today, and I hope that it will stay that way because lots of Africans in America have perished since the Great Migration in these United States, and we know that they have made that migration for several reasons. One, for economic advantage, but mostly to be free of the torment that they were consistently under in the South. So I hope that the flag remains in half mast for in honor of the people who continue to perish. The thing today is about standing on the shoulders, and I recognize, as my thesis advisor wanted me to remember when I was working on my thesis, that some of the shoulders that we stand on, that I personally stand on, is the great Toni Morrison, Octavia Butler, Ralph Ellison, James Baldwin, all of those other people who do not have the luxury of simply being writers. They have to be stewards for activism in their communities, and they have to be people who bring awareness to all of the things that are happening in our Black culture, and I'm happy to, I'm proud, and I recognize that it's a privilege to have a platform, and I continue the work that my ancestors have done. This is One More River. Hi, Mom. Well, my mother, she'll be there, but mother can't help me to cross. You know that mother, she'll be there, but mother can't help me to cross. You know I got one more river to cross. Well, my father, he'll be there, but father can't help me to cross. You know that father, he'll be there, but father can't help me to cross. You know I got one more river to cross. Why was the river we crossed from slavery? Scarred backs, proud chest, acts of bravery. We packed just a little more than pride for that underground railroad ride. The whole while singing, we exalt thee. Only faith could have helped us cross the cold waters when we knew that the sure punishment was slaughter. Slipped, sneaked, prayed for salvation from every station until Juneteenth and the promise of emancipation. The long-awaited freedom for our sons and our daughters. Then came the time that we came to know a formidable foe, a slinky fellow by the name Jim Crow, who did legislate the rapids of the river to flow against us and mark the moment when our people learned not to trust the nation nor the scale or the direction the river flowed. Lord sent us a king to teach us how to fight in ways that were civilized for our civil rights. We learned to sit, walk, and march with compassion against those who held a stake in the profit of our oppression. Held on to their power with privilege, held on to their privilege with all their might. The river's rapids were rough, but the water does still flow. For this renewed fight that we have against brutality, for the continued struggle for equality and equity in the workplace and beyond, and places we don't even know yet, we choose to cross this river to a new plateau. We have one more river to cross. And my father, he'll be there, but father can't help me to cross. You know the father, he'll be there. The father can't help me to cross. You know I got one more river to cross. Thank you for your time.
I just want to say that I am just so happy for the honoree that I've chosen for our Black History Month program. Our theme is standing on the shoulders for us to get where we have gotten. And as the Reverend has said, it's the women who did a lot of the work. There were women and my ancestors sometimes didn't eat at night, sometimes didn't sleep at night, kids, sick children, sick parents. But you know, we must say we appreciate those women that I say I have stood on their shoulders for me to get to where I'm at, because I wouldn't have gotten here without them. And I want to bring up my honoree, and I chose Mary McLeod Bethune because I see her out in our community with her arts and crafts and working with our children. And I gotta say, that's why I chose that, because she has so much patience with our children. She wants to show them how to make the buttons, how to crochet, how to sew, how to do all of that. And I just want to say to my honoree, would you please come up? And my honoree for Black History Month is Miss Helen Louise Hayden. South Carolina to Mrs. Ozella Burgess. And whereas Ms. Kennedy relocated to New Jersey over 40 years ago and is a resident of the Fourth Ward. Whereas she is the mother of four beautiful children, Daniel, Gregory, Warren Jr., and Vanessa. Whereas Helen Louise Kennedy played women professional football for the New York Phillies. Mayor Joey Torres, Mayor Jeffrey Jones, Mayor Ruby Cotton, Mayor Jane William Warren, and now Mayor Andre Sayer. And from 2000 through the present, she has worked for the betterment of the youth of our city and the Division of Recreation as the Arts and Crafts Director, teaching crafts and knitting and crocheting and sewing under the leadership of our director, Assemblyman Benji Wimley. Whereas Ms. Kennedy has volunteered for many city events, including National Night Out, festivals, summer camps, and community events. Whereas she is dedicated to her work and aspires to help everyone she comes in contact with. Therefore, it's being resolved by the Municipal Council of the City of Patterson that Helen Louise Kennedy is now recognized as a 2019 Black History Month honoree to receive the Mary Bethune McLeod Award as inspiration to everyone in our city. And I want to say thank you.
Giving honor to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is the head of my life. And I wouldn't be here today without him. And I just want to thank my family, my media family, my recreation family, my city family, and giving honor to my board, council person, and the council, the honorable council here today, and Mayor Jane, and my dear Sam. I just want to say thank each and every one of you for making this day a special occasion that the Lord has already ordained for me. And thank you for
participating.